Hello students, this is the video related to your new topic started in your class. Now, the learning objectives of the new topics are identify major components of separated system along with describing their functions. The big idea related to the separated system will be you learn about the separated system by developing a simple model. Now, think of a city. All is making of cell, or cells are working over a city. Now, think of your body as a city of cell. Like my body, your body is a city of cells. Then each cell is like a house. Okay, think it. Think deeply. What are the requirements of the house? A house needs fuel, energy, water, and raw materials. And one more thing. It will require removal of the waste, garbage or waste material from the sewage line. Okay. A house also have a sewer system and a garbage pickup system to get rid of the waste materials. Means, think about your house. Your house needs some fuel. Think it. Okay, now your house needs energy in the form of electricity. Your house needs water and other raw materials. Now, it also required a sewer system and a garbage pickup system. Now, your body must take in needed material and get rid of waste material just like a house does. Means our body is same as our house. We require repairment of the house. We require some raw material for the house. We require energy and fuel for the house. We require water, sewage, and so many other things for the house. Same, all these things are required for our body. Now, think deeply. What makes a delivery system efficient? Means you have to provide all these required materials, fuel, energy, water, sewer, garbage, all the requirement jobs with the help of delivery system. Then what makes delivery system efficient? Think, and after thinking, note it your copy and discuss with your teachers in the online class. Imagine you are in charge of package delivery service. You are in charge. Now, what is your duty? What things might your job is harder? Think it, okay? You are thinking and write the answer and discuss this answer with your teacher. What things might make your job easier? What things make your job harder? What things might make your job easier? What would be the most important part of the successful delivery company? And write a paragraph to explain your ideas and include any list, diagram, drawings that will help your explanation. And discuss pros and cons with your teacher. Now, we have a same delivery system in our bodies. That is, as efficient as it's important. Okay, what is the system? This is our system, delivery system. It consists of lungs, heart, and cells. Now, your circulatory system is like the streets of a city, with lots of traffic flowing through the streets to and from different destinations. In your city of circulatory system, the streets are blood vessels, and the traffic flowing through the streets is blood, and the traffic move to and from different destinations. The destinations are your organs or cell. Okay, now we are starting our new topic, which is circulatory system. It means transporting gases, nutrients, waste, and other materials. The learning objective of circulatory systems are: first, define the parts of circulatory system and what they do. Second, point out the four chambers of heart and what they do, means their function. Describe blood vessels and compare these vessels like arteries, capillaries, and veins. And last objective is describe the blood and its parts, means red blood cells, white blood cells, plasma, and platelets. Now, before we get into the heart of the lesson, you need to know some interesting and cool facts. First is, the heartbeat is strong enough to excrete blood 30 feet above. Means the heartbeat will excrete the blood 30 feet. It has a power to squirt the blood 30 feet. Okay. Now, the longer a boy's ring finger is, the less likely they are to have a heart attack. Means, if a boy has ring finger, engagement ring finger is longer, then it is less likely to have a heart attack, according to the study. Okay, now next is, the new human heart beats approximately 35 million times per year. It's beating capacity of humans approx. Okay, now the heart pumps 1 million barrels of blood in a lifetime. Most heart attacks occur between 8 to 9 p.m. This is a fact. Sorry, 8 to 9 a.m. Now, what about the cold heart facts? Heart is a muscle. The heart is a little larger than your clenched fist, your right or left fist. Okay. Your heart beats about 100,000 times in one day and about 35 million times in a year. During an average lifetime, the human heart will beat more than 2.5 billion times. This is the facts about the heart, how our heart works. Now, give a tennis ball a good hard squeeze, then you are using about the same amount of force your heart uses to pump the blood out to the body. Even at rest, the muscle of the heart work hard twice as hard as the leg muscles of a person sprinting. Okay. Heart pumps about 1 million barrels of blood during an average lifetime. That is enough to fill more than 3 super tankers. This is a super tanker, okay? Interesting fact, the blue whale has the largest heart in the world and its weight is 1 ton, okay? And you will convert into kg. The hummingbird has a heart that beats 1000 times per minute, fastest beating of heart. Your entire volume of blood goes through your entire body once every minute. Means your entire blood move towards your body in 1 minute and come back in another minute. Okay. Entire blood volume. Humans have 60,000 miles of blood vessels in their bodies, more than twice the circumference of the earth. If you calculate the circumference of the earth, you will multiply it with 2, then you will get the length of blood vessels present in our body, which is 60,000 miles approximately. Your heart beats 100,000 times and pumps 2,000 gallons of blood every day. Pig and baboon hearts have been transplanted into humans for the transplantation experimentations. Now, the human cardiovascular system. Introduction. The cardiovascular system is a transport system of the body, like this, with the transmission system. It comprises of blood, heart, and blood vessels. The system supplies nutrients to and removes waste products from various tissues of the body. The conveying media is liquid in the form of blood, which flows in closed tubular system. Now, the function of cardiovascular system. It transports nutrients, hormones, removes the waste products. It will use for the gaseous exchange and for the immunity of the body. Blood vessels transport blood, and this blood carries oxygen and carbon dioxide. Also carries nutrients and waste material. Heart pumps blood through blood vessels. Components of cardiovascular system. The main component of cardiovascular system is heart, blood, and blood vessels. Now, starting from the main component of the system, which is heart. The vertebrate heart. Vertebrate hearts are separated into two types of chambers. Atria, singular atrium. It receives blood from body or lungs. Contraction of the artery send blood through a valve to the ventricle. Next is ventricle chamber. They receive blood from artery, contract to send blood to the body or lungs. There are different types of hearts. Here I am explaining one or two types of heart. First one is the two-chambered heart. Means this heart has only two chambers. The simplest vertebrate heart is a two-chambered heart seen in the fishes. Okay, this is a heart of fish. It has two chambers, one ventricle, one atrium, and body capillaries and gills capillaries. That's all. As you know, fish inhale oxygen from their gills, okay, and body capillaries. Next, a single atrium receives blood from the body cells. A ventricle sends the blood to the gills to collect the oxygen, and this is the complete cycle. Okay, Iliad, any problem? Now, this is a three-chamber heart. Separate arteria allow some separation of oxygenated and deoxygenated blood, which was an advantage for land organisms like reptiles and amphibians. The one of the most simplest reptile is lungs, capillaries, and body capillaries. One ventricle and two arteria. Okay, red and blue. The blood can mix in the ventricle. One blood from the blue is deoxygenated blood and red one is the oxygenated blood. Both blood receive towards the ventricle and they will mix. Mixing is minimal. Some reptiles have the partial separation of the ventricles. Means they have some type of valve in their single ventricle to separate the oxygenated and deoxygenated blood in some reptiles. Okay, now last one, which is we discuss in here, four chambered heart, which is in humans. The four chambered heart seen in birds and mammals, which allows complete separation of the oxygenated and deoxygenated blood. This is mammals and birds, four chambered heart, or humans. Have you seen the two ventricles are separated and the two arteria are also separated, which is receiving the blood from the capillaries, sending the blood and receiving the blood from the capillaries, and sending and receiving the blood from the lungs capillaries. Complete separation is necessary to support fast metabolism found in the homeotherms. Complete separation is necessary to support fast metabolism found in homeotherms. Okay, now dual pump operation. First, our heart is a four-chambered heart. It means it has two ventricles and two arteria. So, first step is arteria contract, forcing blood into the ventricles. Both arrows going towards the ventricle. Then, in the second step, then the ventricles contract, forcing blood through arteries to the lungs and the rest of the body. And next is the cycle ends as the heart relax. The four chambered heart act as two pumps. Okay. Human heart. Heart is a four chambered hollow muscular organ approximately the size of your. Its location in your body, its superior surface of diaphragm, left of the midline, anterior to the vertebral column, posterior to the sternum. This is the location. In figure A, different parts are identified to understand the position of heart. Center line, little left of the center line, okay, from the diaphragm, point of maximum intensity, mid sternal line, second rib position, second rib sternum. Okay, in figure B, anterior, right lung, left lung, and in the center heart. Okay, now these are the positions, diaphragm, apex of the heart, parietal, pericardium, pulmonary trunk, and aorta, left lung, right lung, and left lung, and superior vena cava. Now, what about the heart anatomy? This is the heart anatomy and its labeling. Pulmonary artery, left atrium, pulmonary vein, arterioventricular wall, semilunar walls, one way, left ventricle, ventricular septum, heart muscles, descending aorta, inferior vena cava, right ventricle, arterioventricular wall, right atrium, pulmonary veins, pulmonary artery, and superior vena cava, aorta. The four chambers of the heart: left atrium, left ventricle, right atrium, right ventricle. Four chambers of heart and their working. Left atrium takes oxygen-rich blood from the lungs and pumps it into the left ventricle. Then, left ventricle pumps the oxygen-rich blood through the aorta, which sends it out into the body. Now, what about the right? Right atrium takes the used blood from the body. Take the used blood from the body that no longer has oxygen and pumps it into the right ventricle. Right ventricle pumps the oxygenless blood into the lungs, where it picks up oxygen again. And then from the lungs, it will go to the left atrium and its cycle is running on. Function of heart. First, generating the blood pressure. Routing blood means heart separates pulmonary and systematic circulation. Pulmonary and systematic circulation we will discuss in last of the video about the circulatory system. Ensuring one-way blood flow, as we discussed in the starting activity about the CT delivery system, one-way. Heart valves ensure the one-way flow. These valves have special shapes to ensure the one-way flow. Regulating blood supply. It changes in contraction rate and force match blood delivery to changing the metabolic needs. Which set of heart vessels move deoxygenated blood from the body to the lungs? Think it. Which set of heart vessels? Heart vessels, two sets of heart vessels, okay, moves deoxygenated blood from the body to the lungs. Options: right atrium, right ventricle, right atrium, left ventricle, left atrium, left ventricle, or right ventricle, left ventricle. Think it and answer the question. The correct answer is right atrium, right ventricle. Left is taking the blood from the lungs. Okay, and the question is deoxygenated blood from the body to the lungs. It is right atrium, राइट वेंट्रिकल. नाउ इफ योर ब्लड प्रेशर इज 90/70, द नंबर 70 रिप्रेजेंट्स सिस्टोलिक प्रेशर, हार्ट कॉन्ट्रैक्ट्स. सिस्टोलिक प्रेशर, हार्ट इज रिलैक्स्ड. डिस्टोलिक प्रेशर, हार्ट कॉन्ट्रैक्ट. डिस्टोलिक प्रेशर, हार्ट रिलैक्स्ड. थिंक इट. इट इज डिस्टोलिक प्रेशर एंड हार्ट इज रिलैक्स्ड. ओके. Now, the next part of the circulatory system is blood. It is a transporting medium or our traffic flowing to the streets towards on the streets of the city. Now, blood, the fluid that circulates in the heart, arteries, capillaries, and veins of vertebrate animal carrying nourishment and oxygen to and bringing away the waste products from all parts of the body. Now, components of blood are blood is made up of four major components. What do each of these do? First is plasma. It is a liquid portion. Next is the red blood cells, white blood cells, and last one is platelets. Now, components. What percent of your body is blood? How much blood do we contain? On average, 4 to 6 liters we contain in our body blood. We contain about a pint of blood for every 15 pounds of body weight. Okay. Now, the composition of blood. What is the combination? What percent of your blood is cellular? It's 45% of our blood is cellular. And what percent of your blood is plasma? It's 55% of our blood is plasma. Now, the first component of blood is red blood cell. Red blood cells lose their nucleus at maturity. Means, as these cells are growing and mature at the adult age, they will lose their nucleus, and in early ages, red blood cells contains a nucleus. It make up about 99% of the blood cellular components. Means red blood cells is a composition of blood cells components. Its red color is due to the presence of hemoglobin inside them, which will make them red. What is hemoglobin? Hemoglobin is a complex protein made up of four protein strands plus iron-rich hemigroups. So, due to this iron-rich hemigroups, doctors and other specialists and dietitians making you eat an apple daily in order to get better blood production. Polypeptide chain is purple and red, and hemigroup is green. This hemigroup is iron rich, which will make contact between the polypeptide chains. Each hemoglobin molecules can carry four oxygen atoms. The presence of oxygen turns the hemoglobin bright red. Presence of this oxygen makes the hemoglobin bright red. Red blood cells life span, how long they will survive. Red blood cells live about 4 months. Iron from the hemoglobin is recycled in the liver and spleen. This is the process. Oxygen deficiency stimulates and then towards the kidney, then it's again stimulate red blood cells production in the bone marrow, and it will cause restored oxygen level and return back. The hormones erythropoietin made by the kidneys, which stimulates the production of red blood cells in the red bone marrow. Now, think and answer it. If you listening me carefully, if your diet is poor in iron, what will happen to your red blood cells? Think, you will make fewer because there is less iron to make the hemoglobin. You will make more to make up for the lack of iron in hemoglobin. You will make just as many. What do you think? What is the correct answer? Now, the correct answer is you will make fewer red blood cells than if you are getting iron rich diets, like some vegetables, some fruits, some peanuts, and some meat, then you will get good quality of red blood cells in your body. Now, next component of the blood is white blood cells. White blood cells, E. coli, and it's the simplest structure of white blood cells. White blood cells defend against the diseases by recognizing the proteins that do not belong to the body. What is disease? Disease is a type of protein, and white blood cells identify these proteins as they do not belong to the body, and then these white blood cells attack on these disease proteins and destroy them. White blood cells can move through the walls of the capillaries to patrol the tissues and reach the lymph system. Platelets. Platelets are cell fragments. It is used in blood clotting. These are the platelets. These platelets trap red blood cells and making a fibrous network. Platelets are derived from the megakaryocytes because they lack in nucleus. They have a short life span, usually about the 10 days. Okay, next, what is blood clotting? Simplest blood clotting you will understand by the first line. Platelets aggregate at the site of wound. You will get some cut, some injury, some wound on your hand or your leg or on your foot, then these platelets aggregate at the site of wound and heal and repair it as much quickly as they can. They can restore with the broken cells, and platelets release the chemicals to stimulate the thrombin production. What is thrombin? Thrombin converts the protein fibrinogen into sticky fibrin, which binds the clot. Means thrombin convert the protein fibrinogen into the sticky fibrin, and which bind your wound or cut and repair it. Fibrinogen, thrombin, fibrin, and then blood vessels will repair, and these parts are repaired and the wound is closed. As you see, there is a nail, interstitial fluid, nail inside your body. Okay, now What are the bloody truth? Blood consists of red blood cells which have a disc-shaped cell like this that carry oxygen to the cell and carbon dioxide out of the cell. Next is white blood cells. This is the image of the white blood cell. These cells digest the bacteria and fungi, an important part for the body's defense system. You have to take such diet in order to improve your white blood cells for better defense system against the deadliest virus. Next is plasma. It is straw-like shaped, straw-colored liquid component of the blood. It is mostly water, 93%, and contains dissolved protein, glucose, clotting factors, minerals, ions, hormones, and carbon dioxide. These all things are dissolved inside the plasma. Now, next is blood pressure. The heart produces the pressure, and the force of blood on the walls of the arteries is known as blood pressure. If force applied greater amount of force, if blood applied greater amount of force on the walls of the arteries, then it will get high blood pressure. Blood pressure decreases as the heart relaxes, but the rest of the circulatory system is still under pressure. Okay. When blood pressure is taken, the cuff is wrapped around the upper portion of the arm and pumped with the air until the blood flow in the artery is blocked. When the artery is blocked, then presence of cuff is relaxed. Two numbers are recorded. One, first one is systolic pressure. The first number taken is the force felt in the arteries when the ventricles contract. Okay. And second number is diastolic pressure. The second number taken is the force of the blood on the arteries when the ventricles relaxed. This is the system of calculating the blood pressure. Measuring blood functions. Red blood cells, white blood cells, plasma, platelets. Now, it has three main functions. First, it transports all the required materials. Second, it will protect, it will give the protection. And third and most important is it will regulate the temperature, body temperature throughout the body. Which blood cell transport oxygen? Your options are white blood cells, red blood cells, platelets, and all blood cells. The correct answer is red blood cells transport the oxygen. Work together. If a person had a defect in the gene for fibrinogen, what health problems could this cause? If you listen me carefully, then you will give its answer easily. Now, next part is blood vessels. This is our streets in the city. Blood vessels are the part of the circulatory system that transport blood throughout the body. Classes of blood vessels. Main classes are arteries and veins, and the further classes are capillaries. Blood vessels fall into three major classes. Arteries and arterioles carry blood away from the heart. Veins and venules carry blood to the heart. And last is capillaries, which allow exchange of nutrients, waste, and gases. arteries. They are thick walled and lined with smooth muscles. How does the structure of artery help with its function? This is the structure of artery. Artery and second branch is arterioles, and next is capillary bed, muscular layer. Okay, got it? In the muscular layer, artery and vein. Now, blood vessels that carry blood away from the heart are called arteries. This is the internal structure of artery. And they are the thickest blood vessels and they carry blood high in oxygen, known as oxygenated blood, oxygen rich blood. Next is after arteries, arterioles. Arterioles branch of arteries. Arterioles can constrict to direct and control blood flow. They may, for example, increase or decrease blood supply to the skin. How might arterioles be involved when your skin turn red and when you are hot, or a person's face turns pale when it is so much fright or frightened? Okay, think it and discuss this answers with your teachers, that what your skin turns, why your skin turns red and when you are hot. Capillaries. These are the body tissues contain a vast network of thin capillaries. Capillary walls are only one cell thick, means it is the thinnest blood vessels. Okay? And this single cell thickness allows the capillaries to exchange gases, nutrition, and waste material. Capillaries are so fine that red blood cells must line up single file to go through them. Next is, the smallest blood vessels are capillaries and they connect the arteries and veins together. Have you seen the picture? Arterial capillaries and venous capillaries. Okay. This is where the exchange of nutrition and gases occurs inside the capillaries. Venules. They are thin-walled collectors of blood. They collect blood. They have low pressure in the venules, which allows the capillary bed to drain into them. Now, venules are the sub-branches of veins and the main power line is veins. Veins have thinner walls than the arteries. They have fewer smooth muscles, but they do have valves. How do valves and skeletal muscles help the veins function? Valve closed, valve open inside the vein. Okay, these blue lines are veins. Valve open, valve closed, upward and downward. Muscle contraction, muscle relaxed. These are two diagrams of muscle contraction and muscle relaxed. Okay, now move to the next. Veins. Blood vessels that carry blood back to the heart are called veins. Blood flow close valve, blood flow, open valve, and more. They have one-way valves which prevent blood flowing backward. These valves, blood close valve and open valves, are one-way valves which prevent blood flowing backward. They carry blood that is high in carbon dioxide, known as deoxygenated blood, oxygen poor blood. Now, veins have thin walled, large irregular lumen. They have one-way valve, dead space around the veins. They are different types, large veins, medium veins, and small veins. Okay? Now, time to work together. Beside the ability to contact and move blood, why do arteries need to be so thick and strong? Beside the ability to contact and move blood, why do arteries need to be so thick and strong? Okay. Think this question, understand, and what I am teaching you in previous video, in this previous video, then you will get the answer and discuss it with your teacher during the online session. Okay. Varicose veins are veins in the legs that are swollen, stretched, and painful. What factors could lead to this condition and how can varicose veins be prevented? Okay. Now, what is always true of arteries? They always carry oxygenated blood. They always carry deoxygenated blood, always carry blood to the heart, or always carry blood away from the heart. What is the correct answer? Think it. Now, always carry blood away from the heart. Okay, now next. Besides having to constrict to move blood, why are artery walls so thick and strong? Arteries must move oxygenated blood. Arteries must withstand very high blood pressure when the heart contracts. And arteries must move blood out to all parts of the body. Correct answer is number 2. Arteries must withstand very high blood pressure when heart contracts. Due to this, the thickness of arteries is large. Then, why are capillaries walls so thin? Because capillaries are thin and narrow to allow exchange of gases and nutrition, or to allow to force the red blood cells to move through in single file. Think it and answer it. This is the correct answer. They allow to exchange gases and nutrition. Due to this, capillary walls are so thin. Now, work together. Some people who are at high risk for heart attack may be advised by their doctors to take low dose of aspirin daily. What effects does aspirin have that would help prevent the heart attacks? Discuss this question with your teacher. Okay. Circulation. Now, after the three components, heart, blood vessels, there is a process of movement which is called the circulation. There are different types of circulation. Number one is coronary circulation. This circulation of blood within the heart. Next is the pulmonary circulation. फ्लो ऑफ ब्लड बिटवीन द हार्ट एंड लंग्स. सिस्टमैटिक सर्कुलेशन, द फ्लो ऑफ ब्लड बिटवीन हार्ट एंड द सेल्स ऑफ द बॉडी. एंड लास्ट वन इज फेटल सर्कुलेशन विच इज यू विल स्टडी इन हायर क्लासेस. Now, in human heart, there are two types of circulation involved in them. One is the systematic circulation and other is the pulmonary circulation. What is pulmonary circulation? In this circulation, the flow of blood between heart and lungs, like this, from heart to the top, which is the lungs, okay? And in systematic circulation, the flow of blood between the heart and the cell of the body, heart and the remaining body cells. Okay, and here the key of red cells. Red color is showing the oxygen rich, carbon dioxide poor blood, and blue color indicates the oxygen poor, CO2 blood rich blood. Now, features and functions of circulatory system generally have three main features. Okay, number one, fluid, blood that transport the material. Next is a network or system of blood vessels. And last is a heart to pump the fluid through the vessel. Now, next is the types of circulatory system. Animals that have a circulatory system have one of two kinds. Now, one is open circulatory system and other is a closed circulatory system. Open fluid is circulated through an open body chamber and closed fluid is circulated through the blood vessels. Okay, now what is open system and what is closed system? Arthropods and most molluscs have an open circulatory system. This is a open circulatory system. Hemocoel, opening in the hearts. And this is the heart. Okay. Hemolymph is contained in a body cavity. The hemocoel, a series of hearts, circulate the fluid. Now, closed system. Vertebrates, annelida, worms, and few molluscs have a colored circulatory system. It means blood is moved through the blood vessels by the heart action. It does not come in direct contact with the body organs. Okay. Now, this is a closed circulatory system. Next, work together. Why did homeothermy, warm bloodedness, only develop in the organisms with a closed circulatory system? Now, practice your questions. Fill in the blanks. Click the check button for or fill in the blanks in your copy. Number one is the right ventricle pumps blood to the dash. Fill it. Number two, the left dash pump blood to the body. Next, the right atrium receives blood from the dash. Both dash pump blood into arteries at the same time. The left atrium receives dash blood from the veins. Now, let's more practice. Oh, sorry. Answer of this practice. The right ventricle pumps blood to the lungs. The left ventricle pumps blood to the body. The right atrium receives deoxygenated blood from the body through a vein. But both ventricles pump blood into arteries at the same time. The left atrium receives oxygenated blood from the lungs by the help of veins. Next, answer these questions and write down in your notebook. Number one, why are the left and right side of the heart is separated? Okay, now, next is, how is the pulmonary artery different from the other arteries? Next, number three, do the pulmonary veins carry oxygenated or deoxygenated blood? Which one? Oxygenated or deoxygenated? Number four, why is the left ventricle is thicker than the right ventricle? Thank you. Now, in this topic, you have lots of things to discuss with your teacher. And in the next video of circulatory system, we will give you hands-on activity or model making of circulatory system. Thank you.